Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel. We are Rose and Carsten and we are currently traveling in Australia around.
We are going for some fossicking.
This episode we will travel from Bundaberg deep into the central outback of Queensland. We like to get closer to Opalton and hoping to find some opals in this area. Our end point of this video will be Long Reach. On the way, we will look for some sapphires and hopefully we will find some of these precious gemstones. Please, if you haven't subscribed, then it would be a big support if you could consider to subscribe to our channel. Thank you very much, Rose and Carsten, and enjoy the video. Today the situation is a little bit different. Rose is driving.
I'm keeping my eyes up there, baby. I need all my concentration.
Good.
We're here in Merriamvale and this is the big fig. It was planted in the 1800s and it's a massive tree. It survived fires, an accidental fire in 1928. And yeah, they call it the heritage fig tree. Merriamvale's a small town, but they're RV friendly.
These are all bats or flying foxes. Thousands, over thousands are sitting here.
We've turned off the Bruce Highway and we're heading inland, inland Queensland, and we're passing a train. And it is just a mega coal train. It even had an engine in the middle and it's just as long as we can see. We've been passing it for 3-4 minutes already.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's just pretty epic.
I have never ever seen a train engine in the middle of a train.
Yeah.
So there's the end.
There, yeah. There's the end. We're looking forward to being away from the coast and something different. We left our campsite at Dawson's Creek and we're heading towards Duaringa. We're on a dirt road and we're looking for water. We got nothing.
Nothing left in the tank.
This is Duaringa, Mackenzie Park. And there's water. Thank you so much, Duaringa Heritage Society. We got our water done. We made a donation, did the survey, and then we're going to be on our way. We are going for some fossicking. We have reached the sapphire gem fields, the richest sapphire fields in Australia. We're here in Sapphire, and there is an area. There is many areas like this, designated fossicking land. We stayed in Sapphire last night and now we're on our way to Rubyvale. So you can see in Rubyvale and in Sapphire Central, the stockpiles of material where they've been mining.
There's
an operation, and then I can see in through the trees another operation. Wash plants. So we heard there, and even here, this is from mining, the operation mining. You can see where they've gone down and they've had a wash plant, and that is a named a specific quarry. So apparently there are 8 commercial mines operating here.
Okay, today we're at the miner's cottage. And we're looking for gemstones.
Yeah.
You can buy here a kind of washed material which is ready for fossicking. They are saying it has been not processed, this material. It's meaning you can be lucky and find something big there. You never know. and you can see the fossicking tables with all the equipment. And yeah, let us see if we got lucky or not.
So have you guys done this before?
No.
Okay. Now, what kind of bucket are we doing?
Any recommendations?
$30 bucket?
Yep.
Okay, so it's $30. Now that comes with a complimentary cuppa and scones. So do you guys want a cup of tea or coffee? It'd be about halfway through your bucket.
Yeah, why not?
Yeah, I'll
watch you. What is that? Is that the scoreboard?
So that's the biggest stones that get found.
Out of one of these buckets?
Yeah.
21 carat?
Oh, come up, lovely.
And on that side is the biggest ones for the year.
Yeah.
There's someone 62 carat.
Yeah. So that's all out of the premium bags.
Yeah.
And this is not pre-shaked, there's nothing thrown in it, it's just out of the.
So we do always put a layer on the top, because if there's nothing on the top, we can't show you what we're looking for if we put it through.
Yeah.
Flip it and there's nothing there.
But we have heard that it's somehow
not
already pre-washed and pre-shaked and no, so the good stuff is out.
I buy this from one of the big six commercial miners here.
Yeah?
Yeah. And he brings it in a truckload and it's still full of clay and rocks, so it definitely hasn't been processed.
Okay, cool. Thank you. We will try. Okay, darling. Pick one. Pick one and find the 100 carat today. You will pick.
This one is to collect your sapphires in.
Oh, good.
So I'm just going to pop him up here.
If we have one.
Yeah, if you find one. Right, so you've got two zips here. So big grid zip, small grid. So your big one always goes on top.
Yep.
You pop it on top of your black bucket here.
Yeah.
And we're going to pour some dirt.
Yeah.
So you don't want to do any more than about a third of your bucket, or else it's too hard to clean it.
Yeah.
So then we'll pop over here.
Yeah.
Keep it outside of the
box. Yeah.
Really pop it in your Willoughby.
It's called a Willoughby.
Willoughby.
Yeah.
Now, with your Willoughby, two reasons.
Yeah.
One, to clean it. And the other reason is to help center the stones, because sapphires are really, really heavy.
Yeah.
So we just got little pulses on the top.
Yep.
I'm going to give it about 20 seconds.
Yeah.
We want this as clean as possible. So we're going to give it a good
circulation.
Yeah. A little move around.
Yeah.
These sapphires in there already.
So I can too.
Yeah, me too.
Like pieces of glass to me.
Yeah.
I guess they're not.
That's what we look.
What's the green one? A sapphire?
Yeah. Yeah. So our sapphires here, the majority of them are blue or green.
I have seen something green.
Yeah.
It was looking like glass.
That's good. So
should I try it?
Yeah. The more like glass it looks, the better quality the sapphire is.
Okay, but feel nervous about it. Okay.
Right, so now we're just going to grab your top one off.
Yeah.
And these look clean, but they're not.
Okay.
So you want to give it a good push around and get it all moving. Yeah. See how it's starting to get really muddy?
Yeah.
I've seen one.
Yeah. But it'll come clear, darling. It will come clear.
All right, so that should be perfect.
Okay. So now?
Now we want to do a quick flip.
Okay.
So you want to flip it like a pig and you want to flip it towards yourself.
Okay.
So just really quick or else you'll lose stones though.
Okay.
Stuff and over. Do you want to give this one a go? I thought I'd do the big one, take away the pressure. So towards yourself. Yep. Okay. Trying. Beautifully done. And then I always put the sieves back around the right way for next time.
Okay. Just make it easier.
Yeah. Oh, yes, one.
We look at the things that are glassy. Yeah, well, that's definitely right.
Okay, and you'd use the little pickers here, honey?
So the majority of our sapphires here are blue and green. And then your rarer ones are yellow. So we're looking
at that's good.
Is that the sapphire?
Yep.
So there's some yellow ones.
Yep. And then this thing here is a zircon.
Okay.
Okay.
So that's the other thing we also find here.
Okay, and then
a couple of different colours.
It's this one. What is that here?
Yeah.
That's quartz.
That's quartz, yeah.
And that?
That's definitely a sapphire.
But they are looking so bright blue when they are polished and you can look through.
So you can't see through?
Oh, I can too.
Yeah, so okay, not all sapphires you can see through. It depends how hard a life they've had.
Yeah.
The better quality ones are usually the more translucent ones.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so that's the... And we might have missed something there.
That's right, so what I do with those big ones, after you pull the obvious out,
yeah,
get all a good spread.
Okay.
So just in case there's something hiding underneath.
I see that, see one.
Yeah.
Throw it in.
Green one?
Yeah.
That is none here, right?
Sort of grey.
So that's a quartz. Yeah. So quartz. If your quartz dries, it's going to be real dull. If your sapphires dry, they're still going to be really glassy.
Mm-hmm.
So see, like quartz dry, it's got a sparkle, but it's not glassy any longer.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. So your sapphires will stay glassy.
See, there's still mud in there.
Yeah.
Haven't done a good enough job.
You can't get rid of all the mud.
Is that the sapphire here?
So best way to tell is to dry it. See how it's still glassy?
Yes.
So it's definitely a sapphire.
Oh, hey.
Good job.
Okay, now the little stuff.
The little ones.
Stuff, honey.
That would be nice. It would be one here, but it isn't.
Now.
So we got our instructions how to do it. First of all, we have to
fit. Sieving through the two meshes. Could be something inside. Okay, now to the wash. Okay, now. Okay, you wanna. Washing it with your hand. Yep, two separate layers. Yeah. Put it into, yeah. Okay. Now from the top, darling, otherwise you're gonna do yourself an injury. Okay, bottom layer.
So this is what we found here. I mean, these are nice gemstones. I don't know what is the financial value of that. I guess going to zero. However, it was fun to do it. It's something unusual. And of course, we will take it home with us. So now we're going to the lady and she will tell us what is real and what is unreal. What is something worse, which is nice, which is not so nice. But we found a nice selection of green one and some red ones. There's a red one and the big one here. Let us see, and this is supposed to be a big one as well. Let us see. And the price has excluded a cup of tea and scones. We have a scone now.
So we're just looking for the clarity in the stone to see if any of them are possibly cuttable.
Yeah.
And they've also got to have depth as well. If they don't have enough depth, then you obviously can't put facets into them.
Yeah, because they're not thick enough to go through the...
That's a green one, yeah?
Yeah, and that red stuff in it, that's iron staining. So it would have a little crack where iron's leaked into it.
Yeah. Sort of cool, honey. You can put them in a little...
Yeah, you put all your little chips in there.
You put your chips in there and then...
You was looking for buying for Gracie something.
Yeah.
They are a real cutted one.
Yeah.
So what is that and what is that? Good, bad?
So this is the pile that are possibly cuttable. These have had a hard life.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
They're for the rock.
Yes.
So these are not sapphires?
Yes, sapphires, but very, very fractured.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So if you try to put a facet into them, they would break.
Mm-hmm.
This is a red one here, right?
That's a zircon.
Ah, it's a zircon.
Red zircon, yeah.
What's the difference between a zircon and a sapphire?
Well, they're completely different stone, but your zircons only have a hardness of 7, and your sapphires are really hard stone. They're
okay.
Almost as hard as diamonds, yeah.
Made your fortune.
Oh,
yeah, the fortune in our minds, that's all.
Yeah.
The experience was worth all of it.
So this one is a skin polish stone.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
so okay. You can see the color and
so these are the ones you make in the pendants.
Yeah,
so it's a beautiful stone, but it wasn't cuttable.
Yeah
so they're so done with the Dremel.
Yeah.
So they're done by hand.
Like our
greenstone, which we found in.
This is a jade that we found ourselves.
Yeah, so it's done very similarly to that.
Yeah.
And you can shape them and everything. I've just left it in the natural state when I've done it because I liked the naturalness.
Okay.
Yeah.
Great.
So if you decide to, if you're going to drop them in, this is the company here.
Yeah.
I've written it on here as well.
Uh huh.
But this is the company that we use when we're sending things overseas.
Mm-hmm.
And they're located in Bangkok.
Mm-hmm.
So there's their address.
Asylum. Exactly.
Alrighty.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you. There you go.
That's our stuff here. Have a good day. Bye.
Yeah, we really appreciated it.
No, you're fine. You have a good day.
Yeah.
So this is the area, the fossicking area for the gemstones. We just got out with a couple of them, but you can see here everyone is searching for gemstones. After 1 hour washing, picking, we got some gemstones. Okay, this is what we got.
Sapphires.
So this one, sapphires, which are could be possible cuts into nice ones.
These are more gravelly,
too small to cut, they are for show, and this one is for polishing. Also, this is what we found in 1 hour. There is still a lot of stuff onto the ground here, and we highly recommend it. It's a lot of fun.
Yes.
Okay, good. So now we're heading off. We have a long drive for today, 100 kilometer closer to Winton.
Off we go.
We have stopped on our way between Sapphire and Alpha, as we are in direction Alpha today on the way, on a lookout to see something like that here. The vast Australian bush. On these long roads here in Australia, they're having something like fatigue zone wine signboards and with question like trivia games. So the question, what does the Great Dividing Range divide?
There were sunglasses on that termite.
We have passed the...
There's another one.
Oh. We have passed the... And here, closes again. We have passed the... Oh, there's another termite coming with closes or something like that on. We have passed the Great Dividing Range. I think it is separating Queensland from New South Wales, but I'm not sure. Okay, look. Someone was making really fun with this termite.
It's a Ned Kelly.
Yeah.
I think the Great Dividing Range, and I can't see that answer yet, it separates like the hinterland and the outback, maybe?
Okay. Hint, it's above and below ground.
Oh, it's a fault line then.
It's a fault line, okay.
Yeah, that's my answer, fault line.
A fault line, okay. So in a couple of kilometers, no, the Queensland Road Authorities will let you know. See if coming more dressed termite mounts.
Definitely an area on the left here.
Okay, so there is the answer. My answer was most likely wrong, as Rosie's is right. Okay, and. Ahaha, not right, me not right, you not right.
Okay.
It divides the flow of water. We are on Bark Caldine, or the short version is Barky. And Barkey is famous for their tree of knowledge. And now you're wondering why tree of knowledge. 1891, during the Shearer strike, they have founded underneath this tree the Australian Labour Party. And that's why is it very important for some people in Australia, I guess, especially for the people, for the members of the Australian Labour Party. 2006, someone has poisoned this tree, and the remain of the trees has been brought to Brisbane, and then they have conserved this tree, or the remains of the tree, brought it back here to this place, and have built this memorial, which is really nice. And we have heard it's supposed to be really nice over the night. Maybe we will have a see, we can have a look later. However, Rose is up to a famous bakery somewhere there, and I will pick her up now.
Here's our fire, and look at that. It's a fire in the sky. Beautiful sunset tonight. What a big truck has just pulled in. It's not a truck even, it's a road train. Look at that, each trailer has, I don't know if that's 6 or 12 wheels. Amazing, amazingly big. We're heading into Long Reach. Getting passed by a road train. It wasn't so bad. He wasn't as big. Yeah, okay.
Another road train.
So three. That this massive thing that you see coming up is the Qantas Founders Museum. Quite a few people parking on the street. I don't know if we go in. Yep, let's go in and drive around. The Qantas Founders Museum is not affiliated with Qantas. There is a bit about the early history, and there is a museum, main museum, and then there are the planes, which you can see quite a bit from outside. Obviously big, but they're not included in the museum entry price. You need to get a special ticket for that.
It could be interesting to go into the museum. However, the entrance for the museum is $35. It's not including visiting the airplanes or going into the airplanes. For the airplanes, you have to pay $100 entrance. This is for the lowest tickets. It's called captain's tickets or whatsoever. They're having there, it's going up to $160, $180 per person. We thought we'd give it a pass, a rain check. As we have been a couple of times in our life on airplanes, I don't think that we need to have a closer look into that airplane. And basically, we were flying with this kind of airplanes a couple of times, so we will just continue. Sorry, Qantas. And the other thing is the boomer, the parking here for caravans. They are making even a signboard, park caravans, welcome, blah blah blah. But you have to reverse out, and that instead to go in and one side out. However, we will drive over the concrete there.
Luckily we have off-road and we can do that. Made it. We are camping here today at the Dar River, and that is the Dar River. It's a free camp.
I was just looking for some firewood, and then I came across some emus. there I was going back to the caravan, grabbing the camera and was calling Rosen. There are the emus. See, they have spotted us already. Running away. Oh, four. Oh, there's one more. But they are very shy. Look, they are seeing us and suck, boom, they are gone.
We've got the fire ready to go. We've prepared things a little bit because we had rats in our campsite last night. So just in case, we've got the Starlink cable up. Starlink's up and the bonnet's up, so there's no heat in the engine bay and we don't have any rats nibbling things in our engine bay.
Don't care anymore, do you? You're coming to us.
That is a big rat.
No, don't come to us. Leave us alone.